On today's first look, we have a 1965 Shelby GT350. Now, this GT350 has a very special story to it. Jason Billups here, our resident Ford expert. Please tell us about the two gentlemen and about this special car.
Thank you, Craig. Today we've got Jerry Mendez, which is the original owner of this 65 Shelby. And he'd owned the car from 66 until 2013, where it was purchased by the second owner and current owner, LaWayne Musselwhite, out of Alberta, Canada. This car is truly probably the best unrestored 65 Shelby out there as a drag car.
And it has a great story. And please, I'd like the original owner to tell the story, because rarely do we get this opportunity. This is a 1965, and it is 5S242. Now, that puts it in about the middle of the production of the 65s, but it was shipped to Mel Burns Ford in Long Beach, where it sat there as a showroom demonstrator car for Shelby America.
I first, that morning, went to Shelby America with my brother, and we looked at cars, and the 65 models were sitting outside by the K-rail. This is January of 66. And they just looked a little rough, and I, as a young man, I just wanted something that looked new, a new car. And we found out about this car at Mel Burns Ford, and we went there, and it was bright and shiny in the showroom, and I liked it. And I drove it to the Performance Associates and left it to be modified for drag racing in NHRA stock sports.
And what did they do to it to turn it into the sixth drag car? Now, this car is not in the registry as one of the original cars, but that's because it was not done from Shelby America to there. It took a different route, but you have all the documentation. You're the original owner.
I have the documentation, or he has it now. They took the engine completely apart. They clearanced the rods for more clearance because they wanted 50 weight oil. And those things, they redid the cylinder heads for a competition version, which I believe had Chevrolet valve sizes, if I'm not mistaken.
And then you had the hood changed too.
I had the hood changed because it had a metal framework underneath, and I wanted the light as possible. So I changed it for a competition version, road race competition version hood, which is all fiberglass.
This car, when I went around it looking at, please tell us the story about how original this car is.
It's pretty original. Everybody says, hey, why do you have a 66 steering wheel in there? Well, it was bought in 66 and it had a crack. So Jerry said, give me a new one. Well, it's 1966. There are not a 65 steering wheels. That's why the car has a 66. The gauges. Jerry knew the gauges wouldn't hold up to 200 pounds oil pressure when you're fired up. The gauges are in boxes at my house that they're going to go with the car. We have the gauges. He replaced them with Stuart Warner gauges.
Jerry did an amazing job of saving everything.
Everything.
He pulled off
Jerry
the car.
Never threw nothing out. Right down to the bungee cord in the trunk to hold the jack down. Even the windshield squirters have never been used. There's a tie-down sticker where you tie down a 65 Shelby or Mustang underneath the license plate. Well, Shelby would just take the paper off, and what was left, they just painted the stripes right over the tie-down decal or sticker.
And it's still on the rear valve.
And it's still on the rear.
Yeah.
My favorite story is you asking me where the horn switch is. And I said, I don't need a horn for drag racing.
He took the horn switch out. Everybody knows on a 65 Shelby, we tried to find the original horn switch.
Mm-hmm.
Guess what? It was in a box in the garage.
He kept everything.
Put it back in.
Well, it's a piece of history. The story is great as we show all the photos, all the stampings, GT number 6, on all the internal components that they changed, the flywheel and that. They're going to have to rewrite the registry now with the original owner telling the whole story and all the amazing documentation. Tell us some of the invoices and all the paperwork that come with this.
It has the original bill of sale. It has the original Performance Associate papers with everything they've done to the car to make it a drag car.
Well, it's a piece of history. As Jason said, being at SAC and everybody using it sort of as one of those benchmark cars to... They're only original one time. An opportunity having the original owner, the second owner, who's really taken the time to go through the car and explore how original this car is and the documentation. And the best part, it's selling no reserve at our January 2022 Scottsdale Auction, the 22nd through the 30th, celebrating 50 years of the world's greatest collector car auctions. This is your opportunity to own a piece of Shelby history.